The 2.0-liter inline four-cylinder gasoline K20 engine was first introduced in 2001 with the intention of replacing similar models of the B and F series engine, such as the B20B and the F20B. Additionally, the 2.3-liter K23 and 2.4-liter K24 engines are part of the Honda K series. The K20 engine series, like the majority of Honda's engine series, was produced in a variety of variations, each with a specific use and distinguishing characteristics. Let's take a closer look at the K20 Honda engine's design, reliability, and common issues. It's the Car Problems YouTube channel. Subscribe and let's get started. K20 engine overview. Production of the JDM Honda Stream with the new K20A engine began at the end of 2000. It was the first of the K series of Honda engines, which in fact replaced B16, B18, B20, H22, and F20 engines. Later, K23 and K24 were added to this family. For K20A, an aluminum inline four-cylinder block with a 212mm deck height was created. They put an 86mm stroke crankshaft, 86mm diameter piston, 30mm high piston, and 139mm long connecting rods inside the machine. 2 liters of displacement were produced by all of this combined. Balance shafts were included in a few K20 iterations. The iVTEC system, which consists of VTEC for intake valves and VTC for intake and exhaust valve, is added to the new doke head covering the cylinder block. It is aware of how to operate in both the 12-valve fuel-saving mode and the 16-valve dynamic driving mode. The size of the intake valves is 35mm, the size of the exhaust valves is 30mm, and the diameter of the valve stem is 5.5mm. A timing chain with a lifespan of more than 120,000 miles rotates the camshafts. Valve adjustments need to be made every 24,000 miles. The intake and exhaust valve clearances for a cold engine are 0.21 to 0.25 millimeters and 0.28 to 0.32 millimeters, respectively. An EGR valve and a dual runner intake manifold were used to send some of the exhaust gases back into the combustion chamber, which raised the vehicle's environmental rating. The firing order for the K20A is 1342. K20A engines were produced in a wide range of variations and were quite distinctive. These engines were swapped out for R20 in 2007. K20C is the only version still produced today. K20 engine common problems. Leaking oil. Check the front seal on the crankshaft. It is a typical issue, and replacement will resolve it. Knocking noise. Most likely, it's time to adjust the valves. If this isn't done, the exhaust camshaft starts to wear out more quickly. The camshaft should be examined and replaced if necessary, as this is a typical K20 engine disease. Unregular oil changes and the use of motor oils that are not recommended in the owner's manual both contribute to excessive camshaft wear. Rough idle. Experience has taught us that cleaning the idle air control valve or the throttle body is sufficient. Vibrations. Check the engine mounts. In most cases, that is where the issue lies. Timing chain lengthening may be a problem for heavily worn engines. The fourth cylinder overheating was a nasty problem with engines built between 2000 and 2003. Other than that, it is a dependable engine, but it is crucial to use premium motor oil and quality gasoline. Your engine will run for a very long time if you adhere to all Honda instructions and show up on time for maintenance. K20 engines have a service life of more than 200,000 miles,